Welcome to the Frank Prince Show on Madhouse TV. I'm your host, Frank Prince. A little shout out to my last guest, John Ganchi, who's multi-talented actor, comedian, impressionist, and writer. I think I said that. Thank you so much for being on my show. And this week, I'm excited to have the owner of Madhouse TV, Mr. Tommy Maher, on my show.
It's a pleasure to be with you, Frank.
It's a pleasure to
always
be
is.
Here on the show. It's I got to publicly thank you, face-to-face, for giving me a shot.
Hey, you deserve it. You're a good man.
So are you. That's why you're here, you know?
That's good. That's why we do what we do.
When I first met you, and I got to thank Amber Ferrari, too, because I met Tommy at your gig. So thank you. I went up to you. It just seems like yesterday.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, I know. It was, basically.
It was quick.
Quick. And, you know, I just said,
a lot
you
of
know,
things have happened, right?
Oh,
since then?
Oh, my God. Jeez. Yeah. Very much so. So tell us about yourself. You were
well,
in construction.
I was in construction my whole life in New York City. I had a very, very big business in New York, and I mean, probably did every building in Manhattan over 10 stories in there. And that's what I did for my whole life. And I raised my two daughters alone since they're 2 and 4. And now they're actually, my one daughter's almost, she'll be 40. Which is, I mean, it was just my 40th birthday. And I have 6 grandsons that live with me. And I love every moment of that. That's the best part of my life. I mean, without family is the best part of your life.
It is.
But I adore these kids. I coach all their little league teams. I coach their wrestling. I do wrestling clinics with them. And everything, any minute with them is a good minute. I mean, I love it. A lot of people go, are you crazy? Hey, I love it.
How did you get involved with Madhouse TV?
Actually, I did a fundraiser against bullying at, I think it was at Hoosville in Bethpage, I think it is. And Tom Mealy and Vicky came down. I didn't know them, but I think they knew of me. And when I came in, they asked if they could do an interview with me. And I said, sure, you know. And I went outside and I did an interview with them. And Tom said, I like the way you were in camera. Would you come be a guest on my show? And I never heard of it. I never knew I didn't know anything. So I said, sure, you know. And I went down and I was a guest on his show, him and LJ. And then LJ, I think 2 weeks later, went out in the field or something to do something, and Tom asked me if I'd co-host a show, and I did that. And then, like the next day or two, he called me up. He says, "Come on in, I want to talk to you." And I went in, and he said, "How would you like to do your own show?" And I was retired. I'm retired for 7 years, and I said, I'll give it a shot. You know, why not? And it just exploded. It just took off. I mean, you know, I know a lot of big name people in the music business, and that certainly didn't hurt, you know, my show. And you know, once you start bringing in big names like 10 years after, and Vince Martell with the Vanilla Fudge and Cactus and George Thorogood and so many great and then local musicians. You know, I love, you know, Amber Ferrari and Joplin's Pearl and Milagro and Godfrey Townsend. I mean, you know, Andre LaSalle, you know,
yes.
these guys are all world-class musicians, you know, and to get a chance to help them and showcase them and also make the show good, it's a no-brainer. I mean, it's just a great thing, you know, it's a great thing. I love nothing more than seeing people get something out of being on the show, you know.
Right, and your show is the Maverick Soul Hour.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. Well, right now, a little hiatus. I'm actually thinking of going on and doing the show on Sundays at 8 o'clock, like the old Ed Sullivan Hour.
Oh, okay.
And I'm not sure yet because we moved my show and we thought we could slide into a 6 o'clock place, but it's just too early for me to get guests here, you know. Right. So I'm actually thinking it might be, why don't you guys let me know what you think about Sunday night at 8 o'clock, the Maverick Soul Hour. I think it would be a great thing.
That sounds
great. Yeah, I think it'd be cool.
You know.
It's a good night, good time to watch.
And you're a singer.
Yep.
Yep. As well as multi-talented musician, and you have, you know, you're a Woodstock guru.
Well, the Woodstock guru thing is more, it's, you know, people are a little misled by that. You know, when they see the word Woodstock, which is my mistake, but I was at Woodstock. And it changed my life literally because of the spirit that was there. I mean, there was 500,000 people there sitting shoulder to shoulder, everyone's shoulders touching. There was not an argument. I mean, not an argument. There wasn't a fight. There was nothing. Someone had a sandwich. They took a bite. They didn't even know the people. They just took a bite, passed it down. They had water, passed it down. It was paradise, and it never left me. And I will never forget it. It changed my life. I think it made me a much better person. And, you know, Janine and I, we spend a lot of time up at Yaz's farm. We just came back Monday, actually. And it's just a great spiritual thing. And idea behind the page is that it's the spirit of kindness that was shared at Woodstock. It's not so much anything else other than the spirit, the people, how people got along with each other. You know, nowadays you don't even know who lives next door to you. It's the world of
it's
me.
Crazy.
Let me stand still while the planets revolve around me. You know, the rudeness, there's no more morals. You know, and that page, if you guys are interested in just feeling good every day, there's no religion, no cursing, no politics, just kindness and treating each other kindly. And that's all. And it is dedicated to Roy Howard, who I believe did more to keep the Woodstock spirit alive than anyone anywhere. And that show is, that page is dedicated to Roy Howard.
And that's why I asked you, because to talk about
it. Well, I'm glad we got a chance to clarify
because,
that.
Yes, that's
because the Woodstock thing, right away people think Woodstock, it had a lot to do with it. It was what it's about, but it was the spirit of treating each other kindly, which is, in this world we live in now, so rare. It's so rare. And we need to do that. We need to make the world a little better.
It's like helping each other.
You know, I mean, every day I wake up, I try to, the first thought that I can't come to, I write on that page every day. You know, today I think it was just simply, you know, I love you all, have a beautiful day. You know, simple stuff. But it might change, you know, because I do get feedback, because I was going to shut the page down out of frustration, because I'm like, where are the people? Why aren't all the people joining in? Why isn't everybody being a part of this? And I actually wrote that I think I'm going to shut it down, and so many people wrote to me. I mean, one woman wrote, said, you know, she reads to her grandchildren my quote every morning. That alone, I was like, you know what? Even if it's just that, I'm good. I'm good with that. Right. So, you know, if it's helping or touching a couple people in a good way, you know, why not? And you got the haters. You know, the haters,
they're always gonna be that
unbelievable. I don't know what these people are so miserable about, or what is so pathetic in their lives that they have to go after people that are trying to do something good. I just don't get it. I don't get it.
And when you were singing, what were some of the bands you were with?
Oh, God, I mean, endless. My first band was a band called The Tribe in seventh grade. That was my first band. I've been very fortunate to play with some of the greatest musicians. I mean, I was with a band called Vital Signs for 11 years. Which I think had the two best guitarists around, Mr. Russell Bartoszak and Kenny Loeffler, and Bob Batchelor on drums, and Ed McCormick on bass. And we actually just had a little reunion with that band. And then I had the Maverick Soul Band, is where the name the Maverick Soul came from. And the Vintage Revolution, the Blue Revolution, Main Street, so many bands.
And when you sing, you blow people away. It's just like,
well, that's because I don't have any mints.
Like, well, no,
you know, to me, you know, I mean, moves. I'll be very honest with you, Frank. I mean, and people that know me know, I mean, I would rather be in a studio creating music than being in front of a crowd singing, you know, singing. I like it, but it's when it becomes where you're worried about how many people you're bringing in. Is the bar making enough? Are these guys going to be pissed off because we're only going to make $200 or whatever the reason is, you know, that it sucks the spirit of fun out of it. You know what
right.
I mean? It takes what you know, everything you're up there for, it takes it away, you know? Like, I like to sing from my soul, and I like to feel my band members. I want to feel it. I want to be a part of it. I want it to all be chemically balanced. I just want it all right. I don't want to be up there going, I don't drink. You know, I haven't had a drink in 34 years, and I don't want to be up there going, oh, my God, there's only 14 people here that are drinking club sodas, you know. I don't want to do that. I want to just go up and have fun, you know. That's why, like, when I do work with Amber Ferrari and Joplin's Pearl, you know, I get to be with great musicians, and the pressure's not, I mean, the pressure's great because you certainly wouldn't want to mess up on our show, but I love those guys. They're just great spiritual people. They're coming up to Woodstock with me for the Woodstock reunion, 45th reunion. Also, Milagro is coming up, the Santana band. It's going to be a great day. 3 days up at Yazga's Farm in the woods. 80 bands. It's going to be incredible, incredible.
Was the music industry always like that? Bring a following?
No, never. There was always hometown. That was just built-in crowds. I mean, like you went anywhere. No one asked you how many people you're going to bring. They were there. It was a different world. You know, people stayed out till 4 o'clock in the morning. Now, 12 o'clock, I don't care. They're gone. They're gone. 12 o'clock, they're gone. And actually, for the bar business, it's tough. You know, it's tough. It's a different ballgame.
Well, everybody's got to pay taxes and
everything. Well, it's the DWIs, you know, people don't drink. Like, you know, when I was a young guy, everybody drank. Everybody be drunk. I don't know how there wasn't, everybody didn't get killed. I mean, to be honest
right.
with you. And even the cops were different then. You know, like, all right, just be careful, you know. You know, it's a different ballgame, you know. And I don't blame anybody for sitting in there and drinking club soda, you know, because, first of all, you know, you get a DWI now, you know, you're screwed. You know, that's 10 years on your license. You're dead.
No more car.
You know, your insurance is, forget it. It's horrible, horrible. So it's a different ballgame. It's a tough racket, and it used to be much more lucrative than it is now, too. I mean, you know, now Long Island, I really believe that Long Island is the music mecca of the world right now. There is so much talent on Long Island, it's beyond my belief. I mean, I get to see it because I go to a lot of things, and I have them in the studio, and it's just an incredible, incredible amount of fabulous musicians. Incredible. And the sad part is so many of them are so good that will never be even known, you know. But they're so good. You know, that's what the Maverick Soul Hour, that's what I love about showing those musicians, you know.
Yeah, that's why I bring people on like yourself
right. Well,
and
that's,
anybody.
Yeah.
I want to show them off because they don't get a shot.
Because you're not a hater. You know,
no,
see,
I'm
I want
lover.
To see people do good. I love to see people do good. People nowadays want to see you fall on your face. They all, you know, it's
know,
sad.
I want to change
sad.
The world like you.
Well,
you know
go on the Woodstock Guru page.
Absolutely.
And share some love, you know, share some love. Because, hey, listen, man, we're only here for a short clip. It's a short trip. So, you know, let's all just have some fun together. It doesn't have to be that world, you know. It doesn't have to be. There's no reason for it. None. None whatsoever.
And we have pictures to show.
Oh, dude, okay.
But we'll do that after a commercial break.
All right.
We'll take a break, and we'll be right back.
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn?
Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act One will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure.
You'll be happy you did.
My name is Dr. Robert Brevard. I'm here for Multimedicine in Westbury, New York. We're located at 1065 Old Country Road, Suite 214.
Old Spice Body Spray will make you feel so powerful to blow your mind right in front of your face!
Goodbye.
Oh no! I don't... Power!
We're back live. Okay, Tommy, I rounded up some pictures.
Oh, really?
You know, we can show them, and I'll have you explain them.
I'll try. Let's see what we got.
Well, you know these people.
I hope so.
I did my homework.
It'd be embarrassing if I don't see anybody.
A little humor, you know. There we go.
Oh, that's Snake from Canned Heat, who actually you should send some prayers out. He's having a rough time right now. Mm-hmm. Pat Travis. Edgar Winter. Rick Derringer. That's 10 Years After, and my boy Neville Chester's over there in the light blue shirt. That was a great night. Great
love
night.
Neville.
I believe that is Randy Hansen from the Jimi Hendrix 70th birthday party. Juma Sultan, who played congas for Jimmy at Woodstock. That is me with Jimi Hendrix's brother, Leon Hendrix. That is me with one of the greatest bass players in the world. Her name is Kate Deutsch. She is she was only 15 years old at that time. That was also at Hendrix's birthday. Oh, Jerry Velez, also in Jimi Hendrix's band. I couldn't see that one. One of my best buddies in the world, T.M. Stevens, played bass for James Brown and was in the Pretenders for 10 years. I can't really see that one. Oh, is that Vernon Reed from Living Color? That is the Chocolate Fudge backstage at B.B. King's. Vince Martell and T.M. and T.C. Tolliver and Juma Sultan. One of my favorite bands, Les Zeppelin. You guys ever get to hear that band? Incredible. They're just with Jimmy Page over in England. That is myself and Janine with Michael Lang, the guy who did Woodstock 69. That is me at Richie Havens' funeral with Richie Havens' brother. That is, Elliot Landy. Oh, probably the most famous living photographer in the world. And also Stacy Cohen, who owns a dancing cat up in Bethel. That gentleman there is Bill Hanley. He did the original sound in the 1969 Woodstock, and he did our sound at last year's Woodstock. I believe that's us, myself, and Amber Ferrari, and Joplin's Pearl on stage last year at the Woodstock reunion. And that is the beautiful Amber Ferrari right there. That is me with Michael Packer, who runs the New York Blues Society Hall of Fame. That is me, Tom Mealy, and Ron Alexenberg, and
Jim Faith.
Oh, Jim Faith. I couldn't see with the glasses. Jim Faith. That is me with one of my best buds in the world, Vince Martell from the Vanilla Fudge. That's Vinny again right there. Also from the Vanilla Fudge, Cactus, Rod Stewart, Bogart, Beck, and Apice. He played with Ozzy, he played with everybody. Carmine Apice, one of the greatest drummers in the world. That is myself, Vince Martell, and T.M. Stevens at Tanner Park. I believe it was Tanner Park. And that is Godfrey Townsend on my show, getting Maverick with the hat right there. And that is the Destroyers, George Thorogood's Destroyers that were on my show. Great guys. What a great night we had with them. We went out to dinner after, it was great. They're on tour right now, killing it. There's Dino from the Rascals, the drummer. That is Gene Cornish from the Rascals. That is Guitar George Fedden and Andre LaSalle. That is Kerry Carney. Great player. Great slide player, local guy. Unbelievable talent. That is Mr. Kim Simmons from Savoy Brown. Amazing interview I had with him. That is Parita Kitson, from Rickety. That is me, Michelangelo, who is one of my dearest friends, and the Reverend Dennis right over there, too. That was at the Gloria Gaynor show. That is Neil the Monster Ciccone, Teddy Rondinelli, myself, and Randy Pratt from Rickety. They did my show. That is Robert Hill, just got inducted into the Rock and Roll, the Blues Hall of Fame. That is Milagro. No, I'm sorry. That is Vince Martell. That's his wife, Peg Pearl, Pete Bremmy from Cactus and the Vanilla Fudge, and Rusty Blades from Rainbow. One of the sweetest men I've ever met in my entire life, the man who brought the Beatles to America, Mr. Sid Bernstein, who just passed away. What a lovely, lovely, lovely human being. And that is the Haley brothers from Spirit that did my show. Great, great guys, great band. And this guy here, Tom Gent, one of the greatest guys you ever want to meet. He's known for writing the saddest country western song ever written. Wow. And that's got to be pretty sad. And that's myself and Wilson Pickett. Going right before a show in Ocean City, Maryland. Not that long ago. That's Mr. Arnie Goodman, one of the greatest guys around, and Mr. Neville Chester's right there. I think you all know who this guy is. That's Pete Townsend from The Who, which we were blessed to spend the whole day and evening with, dinner, the whole meal. Great, 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 super unbelievable day. And there's Neville. We love Neville and send him our love and blessings. This is a picture you won't believe, but that's me at 11 years old holding on to John F. Kennedy the day before he became president. And my mom and my sister are in the picture on the bottom. We just found this picture a week ago. Amazing, at the Long Island Arena. But that's me standing right. It was an accident. I was in a truck. My father had me in a pickup truck. When he walked out, they said, oh, there's 10,000 people out here. Let him speak. And he spoke, and I held on to his leg.
Wow.
And the next day, he was president of the United States. I didn't know you had that one. Wow. And that's that, I think. Is that it?
I think that's it.
Oh, well. I hope we took it down memory lane, I guess.
Wow. What a bio. A lot of pictures.
Been a lucky guy. Been a lucky guy. Been a blessed guy.
Kind and generous. That's what it is.
Isn't that what you should be?
You gotta give back. Yes, absolutely.
You know, I had great parents. My mother's still alive, God bless her. But we had nothing, but we had everything. I mean, we were poor. We lived in a one bedroom with six people, apartment over top of an antique store. But I had everything I ever could have. I wouldn't trade it for nothing. I had a great childhood, and I had great morals installed in me. And I will forever
be
thankful for those parents.
And so. With pictures, there's a video, too.
You got a video, too. Uh-oh.
Can we roll that?
Is it a rated X one?
No. Something to go.
Chris Ferrara here is going to change his guitar. We have a special guest in the house. His name is George Fenton, and he made this guitar. He makes amazing guitars, and he actually has one of his guitars in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Thank you so much, George Fenton, for play the guitar for a few songs for our show. Now, Janice likes to always steal, like I said, my horn players and things, so tonight, can I have the house lights up just a little bit? I decided to steal who she usually has as a special guest. You see, she usually has this gentleman sing with her, the Maverick Soul, you see, and I decided tonight, I wasn't gonna tell her, so he's in the audience, and I'm just gonna pull him up here. Put your hands together for the Maverick Soul, Tommy Maher!
Say, give it up for Joplin's Pearl and Amber Ferrari.
I'm talking about. Awesome job.
That was a great, that was fun. That was a lot of fun. But I would like to say that, well, first of all, thank you to Joplin's Pearl and Amber Ferrari, who are like my family. I mean, they're like family members. And but also on that, played on that song with me, us, was Frank LaTorre, who was with the King Bees, which the night after that show, he played with Johnny Winter at the B.B. Kings. And Richie Cannata also played on that song from Billy Joel.
Yeah.
It was quite a night.
Well, Tommy, I want to thank you for being on my show. Before, what is this rock here?
That rock came from underneath the stage at Woodstock from 1969.
And that rock has magic in it.
It does.
Doesn't it?
It does. Well, I believe it does.
I think I need to touch the
rock. I think you should.
I need something.
You're going to be all right. I'll even give it a little rub with you.
All right. Thank you.
You can't go wrong.
Thank you all for watching.
It was great. Frank,
thank you, Tommy.
Best of luck to you.
You
know I'm a believer in you, and I wish nothing but the best for you. You're a great human being.
So are you.
You help a lot of
people.
That's
why you're here. Thank you.